regardless of what I'm still all right. You know, this need to go out that we make, spread the word to somebody else. Somebody else may be just the one you need to tell that you're all right, and it'll pass on over to them, and they'll feel, start feeling just like you. I'm all right. Say it again, I'm all right. And you know, a lot of times we just got to believe what we are saying.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever noticed people say things that's not so? But it's make-believe. But you don't have to make believe in Christ.
Amen.
Just know that you are all right. Now I want you to spread it a little bit louder. Let somebody else hear you from afar. I'm all right.
I'm all right. I'm all right.
It makes a difference when you can speak it out loud. And if you say it within yourself, that means you're not really all right. But you can talk yourself into healing and miracles. You can do that because you're talking to God. And when you talk to Him, He'll make everything all right, regardless of what. It's still all right. You may be seen. The song says, I just sing Jesus. Amen. And He's working a great thing out for someone, and I know it to be true. Debbie, come up here. He's working it out. He's going to finish what He started. Amen. Praise God. Just want to take you by your hand and let you know the Heavenly Father says He sees all things and He knows all things. As you know, He knows all. But there's going to come a great miracle for you. A great miracle
coming
to you.
Glory!
It's what He's telling you.
Glory!
You just don't know what God's going to do. But we know, we have confidence in that everything is going to be all right. It's going to turn to your good and to your Amen. Tommy, Campbell, would you come with me? But this is God's way of doing things. And He's going to move in a mighty special way. Tommy, He says, there's great love for you. That which you give, He's going to
come on.
The Father is in the house. He's in the house. Yes, He's in the house to bless, to multiply, to give. We all can just say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
you, Jesus.
Well, John, quickly. Thank you, Father. The Spirit of the living God be upon you. But He has no attention. I see a man in the white robe, and he's just moving in a special way right now, at this moment, and at this hour. I see perfection, spirit of perfection. He's here. Sean, the Lord is doing what He wants to do.
Amen.
I have no control over the Lord. The power of Almighty God. Praise God. It's good to be here. It's good to be here. Thank you, Jesus. If thinking you should find, knock and the door will be open. Ask. It shall be given. He's trapped in your body. May your prayers be answered.
Hallelujah!
May the presence of God be for you.
Hallelujah!
spirit.
Hallelujah.
And stay strong.
Hey, hallelujah.
Stay strong.
Hey, hallelujah.
He's making a way.
Hallelujah.
He's making a way.
Hey, hallelujah.
I'm making a way. I don't know where to go.
Hallelujah.
God is for you. He's making a way for you. May the power of the Holy Spirit just bless everyone that's present here today.
Hey! Hallelujah!
Yes, Lord!
Sister Helen King.
Yes, Lord!
Yes. So.
Yeah!
Hey! Hallelujah!
May the Lord take all the worries away. Refresh, revive, renew your strength. And revive this again and again. May the Holy Ghost be upon you. God is good.
Amen.
God is good. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. There is nothing like being, I heard someone say, in the house of the Lord. He can do all things, anything, according to his perfect will. Bless the Lord. And just bless the Lord, oh my soul. All that's within me, bless his holy name. I see a covering over many of you. God said he's going to do it. There's a mighty covering. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God bless you.
Yes,
Holy Spirit.
Yes, Holy Spirit.
It's all right.
Yes,
Spirit of the living God.
Woo!
Yes, yes. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. It's all right. In Exodus, the 14th chapter and the 13th verse. This is what we need here this day in this hour. Moses said unto the people, fear ye not. Lord, I pray this go all over the world. I pray this will go out all over to as many as hear, as many that see. Fear ye not. And he told them something else, some more things. Stand still. Stand still. And when someone tells us to stand still, that means don't move. Don't move. Even now today where God has placed you, stand still. And he told them to see. See. Now, these are direct directions that he has told him. Stand still. Fear not. God's about ready to do something. And he add, and see. This is with your own eyes. See the salvation. That means this is God's doing. This is what he's about ready to do in righteousness. See. You know, keep your eyes on Jesus.
Amen.
Keep your eyes looking up. See the salvation of the Lord. Of the Lord now. Nobody else but the Lord. The Lord's work. The Lord's doing. And what he's about ready to do for you. Then he went on, he says, which ye, he will show you today. For us, it's close up. It's close up. It's close up. The world message today, be still. And know that I'm God.
Amen.
He said, for the gems and wounds you've seen today, you shall see them again no more, forever. God is ready to fight a battle.
Amen.
This is for you.
Amen.
Just be still.
Amen.
Let him go before you. The Lord shall fight, verse 14, the Lord shall fight for you. And ye shall what? Hold your peace. So don't try to fight a battle. Just be quiet, be still. But watch God move for you. We all can receive a message because we know what we've been going through. And we know what's attacking today. We know a world, everyone knows what's going on in the world now. But that's all right. You're going to be all right. 15, and the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore cry thou unto me? Speak to the children of Israel that they go forth. When he said go forth, mean don't turn around. Don't look behind you. Don't look to the left nor to the right. Go forth. This is a command of the Lord. Just know I'm with you. That's what he said. Just know. And we have to get it in our minds. I know God is with me.
Yes.
Tell you, I know God is with me.
Yes.
But lift up thy rod and stretch out thy hand over the sea. This is what he's telling you to do. Now this is a command from God to Moses. Lift up thy rod, stretch out thy hand over the sea, and divide it. Now who has power like that?
Amen.
God. The one that speaks to you is the one that's going to do the work for you.
Amen.
Okay? And the children of Israel should go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. Obedience. Be obedient. And you won't lose out. And I, behold, I will harden the hearts of the Egyptian, and they shall follow them, and I will get me, look at here, I love this part, I will get me honor. That's what God wants today, is honor. We're not giving him the honor for what he's doing for us right now. I will Give me honor upon Pharaoh and upon all the hosts, upon the chariots, upon his horsemen. Anything that the enemy has, God's going to get honor over it.
Amen.
Whoa! If only we be obedient. Mm-hmm. The Egyptians should know that I am the Lord. Now the people will know that he's God when he comes through for you. This is a day now we're living in where the enemy has brought much upon God's people. And God's people are suffering because of the enemy. God's people don't want to go and join over unto them. That's why the Lord says, be still. We need a God today. Somebody that's strong and mighty and powerful.
Amen.
You don't need a weak God.
Amen.
And he's dividing, as I look right now, he's dividing people right now.
Yes.
Even as the circle of going around and around and around, God has gotten in the midst. And he knows what's in the midst of the circle. But he's getting ready to move for you. The Egyptians shall know that I'm the Lord and I have gotten me honor upon Pharaoh's chariots and his heart. Everything that Satan has set out to do, God said, let him go ahead. Let him go ahead and do what he wants to do. If you can relate the world news. Let him go ahead and do what he wants to do. He set him up. You see, God set Pharaoh up. God knows who will and will not give him honor.
Amen.
So always remember, there's nothing that's happening that God has not ordained.
Amen.
To be. God's going to give him honor in this day too. The enemy may try to destroy everything and come up against you, but that's all right. God said, I'm going to get honor off of that.
Amen.
I want to carry you through so you may understand. Everybody get your Bible. And the angel of God, which went before the camp. Uh-huh. See, there's an angel here. Nothing has changed. There's an angel going before you. In your life.
Yes.
Removed and went behind them, and the pillar of the cloud went before their faces and stood behind them. You're circling, as I said. You're circling by the hand of God. It came between the camp of the Egyptian and the camp of Israel, and it was a cloud and darkness to them, but it gave light by night to these, so that the one came near. Not near the other, all the night. God is keeping his people
Yes.
from danger, harm, and destruction.
Yes.
Amen.
Everything that God is doing, he's protecting you.
Yes.
You're the one that's being protected.
Yes.
Even though it may make people are mixed up today between the evil and the good, but God knows how to divide. The righteous from the unrighteous.
Amen.
21, and Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. And the Lord caused the sea to go back by a strong east wind all the night. How many times have y'all just laid your head down on your pillow and you heard the wind blow?
Amen.
Amen.
God is protecting all the time. I don't see anything that was written years ago that is not now. This is a now day word from God to us. All night long, the strong east wind blowing. It made the sea dry land and the waters were divided. So be unto the people. God is doing a miracle right before their eyes, and they don't even see what he's doing. If you know not the scriptures, then you, how can you interpret God? The children of Israel went into the midst of the sea in the dry ground, and the waters were a wall to them on the right and on the left. Now, this is a miracle worker. I'm talking about God now.
Yes.
Who's able to have the power,
yes,
to lift up the waters and the walls between,
amen,
the evil and the good. Come on. There is power working power,
yes,
right now. We wonder what happened to this one, what happened to that. God has put a wall up.
Yes.
And when God put a wall up, can't nobody get across.
Amen.
He can't come from one side to the other.
Amen.
And the Egyptian pursued and went in after them in the midst of the sea. Even all favorite horses and chariots and horsemen. See, the devil gonna try to chase you until he can't chase you no more. Come on now. He's not giving up all because you say the blood of Jesus. No. No. He says that too. He's got a mouth like we have. But he don't have the power like your father. It's God that's got the power to work in these days and hour and to make the devil be still and get out of your face and get out of your way forever.
Amen.
It came in the morning. The morning watch, the Lord looked upon the host of Egyptians through the pillar of fire. And of the cloud, he troubled the host of the Egyptians. Isn't that wonderful? The Lord knows how to trouble your enemy.
Yes, he does.
See, don't think he's doing this on his own. No. The Lord's got power. He reached out and he troubled them. So they can't work their little dirty works. Come on. Get it in your mind. Take your mind up a little bit higher and say, this is not about me. It's about God. It's not about you. It's not about nobody in earth. It's about God, what God wants to do, just like the Lord take down and he lifts up.
Amen.
The working is the working by God. God sent an angel to work a work in these end times.
Mm-hmm.
I feel the Holy Ghost up. And they took off the chariot wheels, drove them heavily, so the Egyptians said, let us flee from the face of Israel. Whoa. For the Lord fighting for them.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I want to hear.
Yes. Amen.
That's what I want to hear, that the Lord fights for you.
Amen.
I just don't want to just believe it and say it in my own mind, but I want to. He said, stand still and see.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
See the salvation of the Lord. I want to see God fight for me.
Yes. Yes.
Don't you want to see the Lord fight for you?
Yes.
Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? And the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out thy hand over the sea, that the waters may come again upon the Egyptians, upon the chariots, upon the horsemen. And Moses stretched forth his hand over the sea now. That, you know what? I looked at Moses, I said, truly, there had been God in him. Because who can stand under such power? Right now, we can't take just a little bit before we fall out.
Amen.
But the power God has can kill you.
Yes.
He's got power to kill and to heal.
Yes, sir.
And Moses stretched forth his hand over the sea, and the sea returned to his strength when the morning appeared. And the Egyptian fled against it, and the Lord overthrew the Egyptian in the midst of the sea. Something's about ready to happen right now. God is ready to tear down what the enemy has built up. God's ready to tear it down. Mark my word, because the word of the Lord has came unto me. The Lord is ready to deliver his people out of the bondage. The chains of hell, even death, God's ready to deliver them from the enemy that has come up against them. And he's doing it right before your face right now. And some of us can't even see what God is doing. He lift my voice up like a trumpet blow. God is ready to deliver.
Yes.
If the whole United States, God's ready to deliver. God is doing what he wants to do because he wants to do. He sees people are not giving him the honor. He said, but that's all right, I'm going to get the honor anyhow.
Yes.
And my people will not perish.
Yes,
I'm giving my people a vision. Long time ago, they had a vision. And they knew what was coming, but yet and still God said, I take my time because I got to work it out for them.
Yeah.
Something is ready to happen in this whole world. The world is caving in now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's caving in.
Yes.
How many people have eyes to see and ears to hear? But the Lord said, Christian, hold up. I'm coming.
Yes.
Wait on me. I'm coming. I'm going to deliver my people from all of the evil that's come up against them. And I feel this. And only those who will survive, who will believe. If you don't believe, it won't happen to you. But God is looking for faithful few people who will believe in his name.
Hallelujah. Thank
you. The Bible says, the waters return and cover the chariots and the horsemen, all the hosts of heaven. And they came into the sea after them. They remained not so much as one of them. As one of them. God's going to get every last one of them. It's coming.
Yes,
in the day of fighting the battle of Armageddon, there's not going to be one left. With the fire of the Holy Ghost from the Bible spew out of his mouth. God's getting ready to cut down everything. Some people don't even like his kind of messaging, but you might as well look. Moses was a demonstration for now and this hour to come. God said, I'm getting rid of every last one of them. He'll take you and you and you and all the enemies and all that has circled the earth around you. God's getting ready to deliver you. Anything, everything that has come up against his anointing spirit and his power and his Holy Ghost. God don't care who you are, who I am. Nobody doesn't make any difference. When he get ready at that time, it's coming to pass. It's coming to pass. Time is winding up. It doesn't make any difference what generation you're in. Time is winding up.
Yes, Lord.
But God's word will stand strong.
Yes.
God's word is still alive.
Yes.
God's word will not change because we want it to be changed.
Right.
It don't make no difference in high places, low places, wherever place God is visiting, and God's going to move because he's tired of this old generation.
Yes.
Everything has got to go now. If it's not, God's will has got to go. Only God's going to stand at this hour. But I believe Jesus has turned it back into the hand of the Father. The Holy Spirit is alone working under the directions of God. Told by Jesus. Something is about ready to take place. And we need to understand these writings and these scriptures.
Yes, yes.
Is to let us know that the same thing happened then is happening nowadays.
Yes, yes.
So look for the best to happen for you in your life.
Yes.
Why? Because the Almighty God has spoken.
Yes.
And he has given us all direction.
Yes.
Be still.
Yes.
Fear not.
Yes.
See the salvation of the Lord. Watch him work for you. Watch him work. He's getting rid of everything that had damned itself around and about
you.
God bless, God keep, God sanctify. And I'm looking for a city called New Jerusalem to get all his people out of here. It's coming. Take us out of here. Because the worst is coming on.
Yes, sir.
God will deliver his people ever and ever. God bless.
God keep.
Yes.
God's spirit.
Yes.
Is among. Sing this song again. Glory be to God. Amen. God is working it out.
Yes.
For you.
Yes.
Am I not right about it?
Yes.
He's working it out. There's miracles. Even that can tell Moses' time.
Yes.
Working miracles.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen. God be with you. Protect you. All these things in Jesus' name. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
God.
That's who you are. Oh, waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that's who you are.
Miracle worker,
promise keeper, You're the great I am. Oh, yes, you are. My God, that is who you are.
Would you tell the population that God has blessed us to have?
Yes, ma'am. Over 2 weeks, for the first video from 2 weeks ago, Who Do Men Say That I Am, that video has over 29,000 views. And the new one from last week called The Moon has over 14,000 views from Facebook.
Yes,
2 weeks. 2 weeks, yes, ma'am. It's going out to different nations too. One of our great viewerships is coming from South Africa, as well as Egypt, North Carolina, Texas, California.
So what we do is wait for the season and let God go before us, just like I said, be still.
Yes,
and see.
Hallelujah. Yes,
the salvation of the Lord. Yes. So to me, that's what he's doing now. Mm-hmm. He's taking it on out.
Yes.
And Texas?
Yes, ma'am, Texas.
That is wonderful. For the first week, for the very first week, I think you told me it was North Carolina.
North Carolina. Yes, ma'am. Well, on New Year's Eve, we had a service that evening, and Pastor was up here speaking. She was up here speaking, and she said, the Lord told her North Carolina. Mm-hmm. And that one in the United States had the most viewership. So God spoke truth. North Carolina has the most viewership in the United States.
Amen.
Great works you're doing, push it over there.
Amen.
And audience, if you desire to write, it's patriciaturner1@gmail.com. Or what is it on the Facebook? Just as they were just writing and tell them.
You can write on the post, or you can write to the Ministry of Evangelist Patricia Turner page. You can write there as well in the message, or you can write it to the on a post. And make known your, prayers and your comments and, just uplifting words.
She'll appreciate that. God bless you, and thanks again.
Amen.